Hello, Wiley friends. This is me, Mrs. Scott, dressed up as Kermit the Frog. And Kermit the Frog, in fact, is a puppet. So, it is going to be super fun to make our own puppet in the next two lessons. So, it's very important that you listen and learn everything there is to know about puppets. So, let's get started.
You know something that I think's pretend? The neighborhood of make-believe. And of course my young friend was right. Many of the characters in the neighborhood of make-believe are puppets that I make talk. I'll show you, because that's what's in here. Puppets that I make talk. I sometimes use this little bag to carry them, and I always have soft material so that they'll be well taken care of. Here's a puppet that lives in a little schoolhouse in a tree. Henrietta Pussycat.
You meow a beautiful meow. A meow.
Yes, Henrietta. And here is an owl who is her neighbor. My name is X the Owl. Hello, Henrietta.
Meow, 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 beautiful meow.
There are two of the puppets. Here's someone who is the curator of the museum go-round.
Hello, friends. My name's Lady Elaine Fairchild.
And here's someone who manufactures rocking chairs.
I'm a man who manufactures. Hello.
Cornflake especially. And here are some people who live in a castle.
How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? How do you do?
Would you take a close look at King Friday the 13th and pretend that you have a puppet on your hand? And just have your puppet say something to the king. Have your puppet tell him something.
Yes? Oh, I see. Lovely. Yeah.
Was it a scary thing that your puppet told the king? Or a happy thing? Or a sad thing? You see, puppets can talk about anything. Here is the queen. Queen Sarah.
Well, how do you do, Friday?
Well, how do you do, Queen Sarah, my dear?
See, you can make them kiss. Here's Prince Tuesday. Grandpère.
Bonjour, mes amis. Félicitations.
And who lives in the clock?
Daniel Striped Tiger's my name. Hi.
And somebody who always sings what he says.
Oh, I'm happy to be here today. Hello, my friends.
And a donkey who lives at someplace else.
Hee-haw. Hello there. Hello, friends.
Now that you have all of your supplies ready, what I want you to do is I want you to get a piece of scratch paper. We're going to practice how to draw the human face. You can see in my example here, I have an open, realistic mouth. I have eyes. There's a bunch of funky hair there, a nose, and a mouth, and I got some clothes on her. So let's practice first, before we get into making our puppet. We're gonna practice first with the human eye. So the main thing for practicing is to make it as realistic as you can. So I'm gonna try get this document camera all nice and close for you. There we go. And just get a piece of scratch paper and a pencil, and we're gonna practice. So anywhere on your paper, we're gonna make a curved line up, just like that. That's gonna be the top of our eye. And then we're gonna connect it down, just like this. And your eye may have different slants, different sizes. Now, if you look here on both ends, I did another line right underneath that, and that's gonna act as my eyelid. Now we're gonna make a circle in the middle. This is gonna be our part of our eye. And if you notice, I didn't have to make a whole circle because I'm tucking that into the eyelid, just like that. Now we're gonna make a circle in the middle for our iris. This is where our color is going to be. And another little circle in the middle, and that's gonna be a reflection of light. I'm gonna color in the middle, and if you notice, I left my iris color not colored in because I'm gonna use my markers or pencil for that. Colored pencils or crayons, and make eyelashes if you want, long eyelashes or short eyelashes. And if you notice, I did it on the line of my eyelid closest to me. There's two. So you do it closest to the camera. So when you do another eye, try to make it as close as you can size-wise to the other. And how I like to do in between is two fingers, or imagine there's another eyeball in the middle. So we're gonna do the same thing I did to the first eye. I made a little line going up, and I connected it going down, and I made an eyelid, another circle, and then a reflection light in the middle, and then I colored in that part in the middle. If you look in a mirror, you can see that you too have a little black spot in your eye. And you notice the big circle behind that little black circle is not colored in. That's where your iris of your eye is, and that's what we're gonna have for our colors. It can be blues and greens or brown. So just like that. Now, go ahead and practice a few more times on your eyes. Let's work on our nose. Noses are easy. So just make a little, kind of like a long U, and then a little tiny circle on the side of each U, and you're gonna color that in. Then make a line go down on each side, and then you can connect that piece up. Noses are really fun to practice as well. So just because I haven't practiced a lot on my paper, doesn't mean you don't need to. Go ahead. And if you want to pause the video and do a bunch of practice noses and practice eyes, you certainly can do that. I have so much fun doing the noses, so I'm gonna make another one. And they can be all different. Some can be skinny noses and chunkier noses. Just practice all different kinds of noses. There's another one. I'm gonna let you go ahead and practice. I'll show you how to make the lips for our lips, you can make big lips, skinny lips, usually for boys. Boys have little skinnier lips than girls, but it doesn't matter. Start off by making a letter M, but make it kind of wide. And then you're gonna connect that little letter M with a line. And then you're gonna make another U under your connected letter M. And then just go up on both sides and make two little U's. So there's one mouth. Let's make a skinnier mouth. So I have a big wide M. I'm gonna connect that. And I'm gonna make a U just like that. There you go. And then I'm gonna make a U on each side. You can see it's a little different. That smile's not as big as the other one. So what I want you to do is I want you to practice that. Pause the video and practice eyes and practice noses and practice some mouths. It's pretty fun to kind of fill up your whole page and just practice. So pause the video and do that. And then come back with me with your paper bag. Okay, now that we have practiced, you can see my finished puppet here, and it has that realistic face, how we practice together. Go ahead and grab your paper bag, and you want it in front of you with a big flap open towards you, and then you want the writing of your bag on the bottom. We want to make sure your hand can go up inside there. So try not to get confused and do it backwards. Make sure your flap is on the top. And you can see there's a little piece of line. There's a little line on your paper. We're gonna start with the same eye as we just practiced. So go a little bit above that line on your paper bag and go ahead and make that eye. Erase a little bit here. I did it too low. So make a big line going up and then connect it going down just like that. Then make your eyelid in the middle. Let's do our next one. Put two fingers in between, big line going up, connect that down, just like that. And all of our eyes will be so different and it'll look fabulous. And try to make it as symmetrical as you can, which means they are the same. Do the best you can. So we're gonna put another line underneath that for our eyelid. I'm gonna draw it in a Sharpie so you can see it just a little bit better. I went up and I connected it together. Same thing on that side. And I connected it together. And it's right above, again, that line. There's a little line on your plastic bag. And then make a matching line underneath for the eyelid. And let's make a circle in the middle. Remember, you don't have to go all the way for the circle. It's just the sides of your circle because it's kind of tucked up in your eyelid, just like that. If I'm going too fast, make sure you pause your video. And you can see my eyes are not perfect, and that's totally fine. Now we're gonna make a circle in the middle. And another circle in the middle of that to give us a reflection of a light. There we go. Just zoom in as much as I can here. Now let's work on our nose. In the middle of our eye, underneath that line, I try to get it in the very middle of the eye. We're gonna make our U, and we're gonna connect two little nostril circles, just like that. And then we're gonna make a curved line down on one side and down on the other. And then we're gonna connect it right up above the nostril, just like that. Beautiful. I'm gonna make some eyelashes up on my eyes. I forgot about those. So if you want to make eyelashes, you can, or you don't have to. Whatever you want. I kind of like long eyelashes, so I'm gonna make long eyelashes on the top and on the bottom, just like that. There we go. Okay, now let's work on our lips. You can see my flap there. We're gonna do the top of our M. Make a line with your pencil, press that down, and press that flap of your paper bag down and make a line. And at the middle of your nose, imagine there is your M. There you go. Now, if you want a big lips, make a big M. If you want skinny lips, make a skinny M. So there's my line I made. And I made my top of my M. Okay, now we're gonna connect our M underneath that line of our flap. We're gonna connect the M and go up on one side above the flap and make a line and two little U's. There, now we made our mouth. Fix my document camera here. I'm trying to get the lighting just right. Okay, now this is where we're gonna work on the inside. Move your flap up and you can see where your M ends. Make a little line there. Flip it over and make a little line. Same thing there. See where your M ends? We're gonna make a little line. So you can see there's two little marks. Now, we're gonna make a straight line all the way down to where our mouth meets. Two straight lines all the way down, all the way through the line of our paper. Kind of made a big rectangle. Now let's make some teeth at the very top. Kind of like little tiny squares. However teeth you want, I'm just gonna make squares all across. And then I'm gonna do the same thing to the bottom. Where I made that line before, I'm gonna make teeth at the bottom. I'm gonna connect it to that line just like that. There. Now for the tongue, I'm gonna make another M. An M there, and another side, right above that bottom teeth, as far up as you want. And now I'm gonna make that little black thing in the back of your mouth. It's kind of like a big M on that. I don't know what they call those, but we're gonna make that anyway. Now grab a black marker. If you don't have black, you can use brown. But we wanna make sure now that we outline everything in black. Even that inside of your iris, we're gonna color that in black. There we go. And let's do our nose in black, and I like to color in my nostrils with the black as well. Again, you can always pause the video if I am going too fast. Just like that, there we go. Let's make some eyebrows. From the beginning of your eye, go up a bit, and we're gonna just make a shape, a straight line down, and then we're gonna connect that over. Straight line. Make kind of a diagonal line over and connect it. Just like that for your eyebrows. There. It's looking good, guys. Okay, now let's flip it up and let's outline all that good stuff that you drew in your marker. So we're gonna outline our teeth just like that. And you can have a gap in your tooth if you want. You can have it, you lost a tooth. Anything you want. I just made teeth all the way across, or you don't have to have teeth. It just kind of adds to your puppet. And there's our little doohickey in the back. If you guys open your mouth, you can see that black little thing hanging down there. Back of your mouth. Okay, now is the fun part. We get to color. Now, white always shows up really well on these brown paper bags. I'm gonna put the white of my crayon on the sides of my eyes, just like me and you have, and then a white in the middle. And same thing with this side. And then I'm gonna do white for my teeth because this white shows up so well. You can use a white colored pencil if you like, anything at all. Okay, now go ahead and paint or color your puppet any way you want. You can use crayons, markers, colored pencils, anything. I'm just gonna make mine kind of fun. I'm gonna even put makeup, eyeshadow on the top of my eyelids. You certainly don't have to. Favorite color is purple, so I'm gonna have purple makeup on mine. So go ahead and color your puppet how you want. I'm gonna add some pink for my cheeks and some red for my lips. Okay, now that I'm just about done with the inside of my mouth, I'm gonna show you, you can make some white little highlight marks on your mouth to make it even more realistic looking. So there, there's my inside, and you can see where I put some white over the marker I used on the bottom of my lip there for a realistic look. Oh, that was a big lesson. Okay, so what I want you to do is I want you to save your puppet. Put it in a very safe place because next week we're gonna do hair and her or his clothes. Woo, making a puppet is fun, but a lot of work. I'm ready for a break. How about you? Okay, keep your friend in a safe spot until next time we meet, and we will create hair and clothes. Bye-bye for now.